He wants to go to the crate, so he's decided to call it. Now, as much as I love working with Dr. Angelo, our parrot that we work with here at the zoo, what I have with is a pet, probably not. Cockatoos in particular, definitely not. Reason being is because there is actually a few reasons, when I say reason being, why I wouldn't have these guys instead. They are beautiful animals. I'd be lying if I said they didn't make incredible companion pets, absolutely do. The problem with them is just the amount of time and effort that you have to put into them. So those of you who've got cats, cats are pretty docile and relaxed, pretty easy to take care of in general. These guys are actually more like looking after a very, very, very anxious dog. They do get very strong separation anxiety when you leave the house. And they are significantly more intelligent than your very, very anxious dog. So these guys here, cockatoos generally, we consider them to have the problem-solving ability of a three-year-old. And then cockatoos in general, they have the destructive nature of a child stuck in their terrible tubes as well. So just about anything wood that they can get a hold of, they will try and destroy it. Guests, window frames, here above, of course, they've absolutely demolished the door frames. And they take Persian door. And these are all natural behaviors that they do in the wild. We're actually going to take a lovely duck from home. This is the last break of the day. Off we go. So I wouldn't recommend having these guys spit. They do take a lot of specialized care. Their diet's quite expensive as well. The amount of attention you have to give them is almost endless as well. So I'm going to have a little jibber jabber about our lovely ducky there. If you guys have any questions, I'm right here. And if not, you guys enjoy the rest of your day here at the zoo. I do believe we'll have another break here. Not again.